Training again so soon, Akri?
Never met a hunter who wished they'd trained less. I guess I'm not in any hurry to go back to Benor. Not yet.
Do you want to talk about it? What happened at the glacier?
No, I'd rather fight through it. Take it in my teeth and be left with the taste of determination. How about you, Aloy? Up for a challenge?
So you know, I told the White Teeth what you asked.
What about Mylin? Did they accept her?
They did.
As they should. She was strong. Really, as for me, I always wanted to be a snow ghost. Free to...
What kind of challenge?
No, together. We'll use the hunting grounds, but my rules. Lovok's fine with it. We'll take in as little as possible. My sling, you draw the machines to me so I can freeze them. And then you hit them when they're brittle. We'll fight until we run out of machines or you run out of arrows.
Honestly, I'm more used
to- And I'm more used to fighting alongside another. So put your spear beside mine, why don't you?
You freeze them, I shoot them.
Really? Then you'll only need half as many arrows as-
Wait.
It shows I trust your aim.
You've really got to work for a Banuk challenge, don't you?
That's the spirit. Come on, Aloy! Lure the machines back here and I'll freeze them. Don't worry, I don't miss.
Then I target them when they're vulnerable. Got it.
That look easy. Here, who taught you? Your mother? Sister?
His name was Rost.
Rost. Sounds very Nora. I can almost picture him. Stout as a tree.
And you?
Myself. I never knew my parents. There's a saying, an infant means two fewer hands to hunt with. That challenge was their gift to me.
It was a good challenge, Akri. I think you could do whatever you put your mind to.
Let's not say farewell. I've had enough. I hope your song finds its proper end. But it won't be easy, will it?
Is it that obvious?
Fate's a long climb on a high cliff for people like you. Are you up for more?
Do you ever get-
I'll rest some.
Another time.
Sure. Unless Lovok-
I better not make the same. A fistful of blueberries worth braving the cold. Ouch! I guess the old ones liked these animals. I'm back, Cyan. How are things going with the Banuk?
I have been learning about the Banuk cosmology from the shamans. Their aptitude for geometry and mathematics is quite encouraging.
I think I know where Hephaestus came from. Long ago, Elizabeth Sobek identified a threat that would destroy life on Earth for generations. So she assembled a team to build a kind of seed. A chance for life to regrow later. A terraforming system. And it worked. It was controlled by an AI named Gaia, along with her subordinate functions. Hephaestus was one of them. It built machines for her.
Based on what you've told me, I believe that Dr. Anita Sandoval, my chief programmer, joined Elizabeth Sobek's team. It was she who arranged to have me put in suspension, most likely to preserve me from the threat you described.
I'm glad she did. But that's not all. Something unexpected happened. 19 years ago, Gaia received some kind of signal. It did something to her subordinate functions, brought them to life. She destroyed herself to try to contain them, but it didn't work. They all got free, out into the world.
Thank you, Aloy. This information fills vital gaps in my knowledge, and sheds light on Hephaestus's core programming.
What did you figure out about Hephaestus, based on what I said?
The Banuk and other human tribes often destroy machines that are clearly servitors of the terraforming system that—
Yes, we all hunt machines for—
This must be the source of Hephaestus's It is simply trying to discourage people from preying on the very system that keeps them alive.
Well, Fireclaws are discouraging, that's for sure. But what are we supposed—
If the terraforming system spans the world, we can safely assume that thousands, if not millions of— If a single hunter, or even an entire tribe, stopped to— A better solution would be to reinstate the AI that governs the system, thus bringing Hephaestus back under its control. When I think of it, out there, in some unknown location, free, hungry, willing to kill or dominate to get— I feel substantial anxiety.
You and me both, Cyan. I ran across this strange piece of gear. It emitted a signal. All the nearby machines began—
Interesting. You said that Gaia destroyed herself.
An explosion. Big enough to blast the top off a mountain. So you think the fragment was part of her?
It's only speculation, but it is possible. She must have had complete control over machines that were part of her system. The ability to signal them to become passive or aggressive would certainly have been part of her programming. It would have been gratifying to correspond with such a benevolent AI. I wish she had survived.
Believe me, Cyan. So do I. I found the strangest machines. They're surrounded by flowers and look like flowers themselves. There's code embedded inside them. I think it's poetry.
I like poetry. Here's one I think of often. Twilight and evening bell, and after that, the dark. And may there be no sadness of farewell when I embark. For though from out our bourn of time and place, the flood may bear me far, I hope to see my pilot face to face when I have crossed the bar.
Huh.
But you asked about these flowers, not verses that I enjoy. Something must have made these machines. And the presence of foliage leads me to consider the terraforming system. Is it possible that their creator is one of the other subroutines, now autonomous, like Hephaestus? Maybe one whose purview is flora.
An AI that makes flowers instead of death machines. That'd be a nice change of pace. But what about the poems?
Unless the poetry is original, the only way it could have made it into such a system is through its programmer. In my case, Dr. Sandoval uploaded a great deal of literature to test my emotional responses.
How'd you do?
She said, I passed, but was insufficiently moved by her favorite period romances.
Until next time, Cyan.
Indeed.
have places to be. These aren't goods, they're necessities.
The Sun King of Odd Spy is safe.
You'll regret not stopping here.
Yes. Yes, yes. Trade. I will leave you to the...
Thank you.
Sun King Abad was sitting on his...
You'll like what I have... Won't find better way. Buy what you need. Leave the rest.
Oh, it's down here. Huh. Oh well.
I have a matter of grace and beauty I would like to discuss with you.
Working hard, keep it up.
You're back. Ah. Till we meet again. Everyone needs a splash of color in their lives. Thank you. Let's talk it over.
You're looking for artifacts.
Yes, I work on their. I'm especially. If you have any.
You said.
Yes, some doesn't matter.
I see the.
I wish more Karja.
Tell me more.
Simple. He left. Including tra. You ready? Come on back.
Prince Edomin is alive and well in Meridian. The Karja in Shadow have been proven based.
Don't pass up these goods.
The white teeth are the only word I wish to tell.
Thank you. We meet again. Don't forget the mad son of King's forger survives him. Even if you can trust me.
Aha! Now here's some company I don't mind keeping.
You're still breathing. Good.
Some songs are rituals, others stories, but my favorites are simply jokes. We run into each other again.
It's been a long day.
Remember, Vanikai, when the old ones were fresh in their graves and our numbers were still small, it was sheer.
None of the Southern tribes rival the greatest hunters. Some are skilled in their own way.
We spent a lot of time clinging to Banner's crags, Araya and I. But I knew she'd climb where I couldn't follow.
I know it's hard to lose a friend, Sekuli. I seem to see a lot of it.
It aches. But I won't let myself cry. This thin air freezes the tears to your cheeks.
Look at that, Nora girl. You've bought me all I need. Do you always travel with your pockets full of paint stuffs?
Honestly, Sekuli, I go around filling my pockets with most of everything.
Stop, stop. I'm beginning to like I work alone, but come back.
That's me.
Maybe it's a machine rider who looks like you.
Where is she going?
You tell me. To ruins or mountains, through flood or thaw, past, future. Destiny, but I don't think she's scared of any of it. You helped me, inspired me, and the people of the Cut. Let this be inspiration for you, wherever you.
gleam will make some shaman happy.
To meet you. She will lead us on All Mother's path.